Darren Vaught here with another USA Baseball alum catching up just prior to the holiday season. This time it's a recent alum, member of the collegiate national team just last summer, Jeff Criswell. Jeff, how are you, man?
I'm doing well, Darren. Thank you for having me. It's been going well so far, so thanks again.
Out of Michigan, of course, is whom you represented when you were playing with Team USA over the summer, then taken by the A's in the second round. Let's start with your Team USA experience, because it was your first with us as an organization. What was your reaction to being invited to represent your country? I mean, obviously, to be deemed one of the most worthy of that a spot on that team, or at training camp at the very least, one of the best players in all of college baseball, and then you add in the element of representing your country. What were your emotions going into that?
Yeah, you know, I've wanted to play for Team USA for a long time. So, you know, when I got the phone call from Eric Campbell, I was incredibly grateful, incredibly excited. It was actually very surprising for me. We were playing in the College World Series, and I wasn't really sure what kind of my next step was going to look like after we were, you know, wrapping up the season. I wasn't sure if I was going to play summer ball or kind of what that next move would be. And when Eric called me and asked me if I'd come out and play for USA, you know, I couldn't have been more excited and more surprised. And like you said, you know, being able to represent my country is something that I've wanted to do for a long time. So to be able to get that opportunity, it was incredible.
Jeff, we might have talked about this even in the past, but I know for a lot of guys, when they travel with whatever Team USA squad they're with, when they are representing us and our organization for a summer, a lot of them experience international travel for the first time ever. Now, you guys played in North Carolina, but you also got the chance to go to both Taiwan and Japan. What was the experience like given that international aspect for you?
Yeah, it was definitely a very eye-opening experience for me. I had traveled to Asia before with my family. So I'd been to China and a couple different cities throughout China. So I thought I kind of knew what to expect going in. But then, you know, taking it from a baseball side of things and actually going to a different country to play, it was just an incredible and completely new and unique experience that I don't think I could have ever prepared myself for. Just the different fans and the different stadiums and just the whole atmosphere of everything. It was incredible. So it was a lot different, but it was something that, you know, was really cool and really, really nice to be a part of.
You mentioned the fans and the atmosphere. What would you say were the biggest differences between, say, you know, pitching in a game at Michigan and then pitching at one in Japan in front of fans who, you know, it's the same game. It's the same kind of, it's the same energy, but maybe not the same kind of energy, I guess, is what I'm getting at.
Yeah, it's a little bit different over there. You know, they have kind of some people who cheer, like cheerleaders. I know they have like the clackers and kind of some of the noisemakers. So it's definitely a lot more of an intense atmosphere over there. Just kind of, it's constant. You know, there's always noise coming from every which direction. So, not that the fans here aren't amazing. You know, I love my home, you know, home fans here. Michigan and in the United States, but definitely just a different atmosphere and kind of a different vibe. So something really cool to be a part of.
So at Michigan, you played for two seasons, including the run to play in the College World Series, with the third getting cut short. How did you make the decision to leave early, especially after coming so close to the College World Series title that time around? And obviously weird circumstances for just about anybody. I think maybe a second round pick justifies leaving. How did you weigh out those options in your mind?
Yeah, you know, it was definitely a thought at one point, just having that season cut short and coming so close. You know, I definitely felt like there were some things that were left to be done at Michigan that I wasn't necessarily able to accomplish, but I thought, you know, after talking with my family and my agent, you know, I think just we decided that was the best option for my, you know, career going forward was to enter professional baseball after my junior year and really start to kind of attack that, grind of the minor leagues that everybody knows, you know, starts, you know, right after your junior year. So, you know, that's kind of where I saw it. You know, I thought that was the best move. You know, like you said, I was fortunate enough, you know, very grateful that they selected me as high as they did. So, you know, that was also another reason that I obviously wanted to, you know, be a part of the organization and get going.
And I know you're still currently working on your degree from Michigan, right? So like, yeah, at the end of the day, the schooling is always going to be there. You still get the great degree that you were in it for from the beginning, and you get the benefit of being able to play professional baseball. I mentioned the A's were who drafted you. They also drafted your father, who played at Western Michigan. What kind of impact did he have on your baseball life, even from an early age?
Yeah, I mean, from an early age, he was the guy who introduced me to the game, and he was my coach growing up. He'd kind of been in my corner, and he's been my rock throughout my entire career. You know, he coached me for a long time and kind of, I think, put me on the right path for success. And then as I got older and started getting into some more serious travel baseball and things like that, he took a step back. But, you know, my dad's been, like I said, my rock, my number one supporter, and I can't be more grateful for everything he's done for me. Having him, you know, have played for the A's and have been a professional baseball player, I think gives some unique insight, you know, that I got going into my first professional season. And I think that was something that was unique and pretty cool that he was able to provide for me. So, yeah, like you said, you know, it was a really cool thing to be drafted by the A's. You know, I never really thought that would happen just because, you know, what are the chances with my dad and everything. So, really, really cool experience for me and my family. You know, it was awesome. So,
at what age did you realize, hey, I want to chase the same dream that my dad chased and achieved? Because I think, like, do you even remember a time when that wasn't the case?
Yeah, you know, I think when I found out my dad played professional baseball, I think, you know, when he finally told me, I was like, hey, wait, now that sounds pretty cool. I think I want to do that. You know, growing up for so long, I thought, you know, he was just a businessman or whatever. And then, you know, as I kind of learned more and more about his career, it definitely inspired me and motivated me to play professional baseball. And that was definitely a driving factor. You know, like I said, I don't know if I can put an age on it, but when I found out, you know, I was probably 9 or 10 or whatever. Or when I fully realized that, you know, that was what he did, I think, you know, that was my goal to follow in his footsteps. So.
So you had this combination of, I guess, his guidance into a professional career, as well as both your collegiate and collegiate national team experience. I mean, all of these things, I'm sure, have helped in different ways as you start your professional career. How specifically did playing for Team USA add to what you bring to the mix?
Yeah, you know, I think the biggest thing that I took away from Team USA was just, you know, being surrounded by such good players, we were able to kind of feed off of each other, learn different things that each guy does well. You know, maybe one thing that I do, somebody else doesn't do as well, and vice versa. So I got to learn a lot, you know, pick the brains of not only different players, but the amazing coaching staff that we had. So just to kind of be able to take different, you know, bits and pieces from each team that you play for, and kind of help shape that into the way, you know, you approach your game, is just how I've looked at it. So USA was a tremendous opportunity for me to gain more knowledge and kind of hear things from a different perspective, and learn about different programs and what guys do at different colleges and different things. So I think it was a really, really good opportunity for me to be able to kind of hone in on different things that, you know, maybe I wouldn't have heard specifically at Michigan or, you know, wherever else I'd be, you know, playing.
A former coach of mine used to constantly harp that baseball is a game of adjustments. It seems like, given the tricky circumstances of the last year-ish, there have been a lot of adjustments for everybody. The pros, you know, at the youth level, there's just been adjustments abound. Given that it is your off-season, how do you plan to own the off-season, given some of the weirdness around how you got to do things and manage these days?
My plan for the off season is to stay around here in Ann Arbor. We have a pretty solid group of professional guys who come back to school, whether trying to finish their degrees or, you know, just like hanging out in Ann Arbor. So we all kind of get together. There's a place called K2 Baseball that actually two of our former players started. Ben Kaiser and Jimmy Kerr. So they opened up a baseball facility in Ann Arbor. And with, you know, all of the COVID protocols and things like that, some of the pro guys are able to go back in there and work out and attack the offseason. So I'm planning on being here with my roommates, Jordan Wogu and Jack Blomgren, you know, two former Michigan baseball players, and attacking it with those guys and getting after it with this kind of group of Michigan professional baseball players.
Nice. Now, Jeff, because we are approaching the holiday season, what are some of your favorite holiday memories? Well, I mean, baseball or not, it's not typically the time of year in which you would play baseball. Do you have certain traditions that come to mind when you think of the holidays?
Yeah, definitely. I usually spend the holidays at home back in Portage, Michigan, where I'm from. And every year we do a fondue dinner on Christmas night. So that's kind of the,
nice.
The one thing that always sticks out for me. Is that fondue dinner with a bunch of cheese and bread and, you know, the whole nine yards. And then my mom does an actual dessert fondue as well, with chocolate and fruit and some stuff. So that whole meal and the whole kind of Christmas fondue dinner, you know, just growing up every year, that's the tradition and, you know, what I'm looking forward to every year.
Nice. That's a good spin on Christmas, right? Not every family's doing fondue. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. So it's a little different, but I enjoy it.
Do you have maybe a favorite gift you ever received? I know for me, it's a very specific glove that I got one year. It can be baseball specific or not. What's the favorite gift that you've ever received?
Yeah, it's funny you said that. I would actually say my first A2000. I got a blue and black A2000. I think it was my freshman year of high school. And that was, I guess, my first real glove, you know, the A2000, the nice leather. And I just remember opening that thing up and, you know, being ecstatic. It was definitely, you know, probably the most happy I've been to receive, you know, a baseball gift for sure.
All right. So I see you've got the USA baseball flag in the back there. We love that. You're rocking I mean, I don't even know that that's been available for that long, the Just Do It Nike tee. You might have already done a wish list binge on usabaseballshop.com. Is there anything on there currently that catches your eye as like a holiday wish list item?
I have. Yeah. I was checking out the website a couple of days ago and the two things that stood out for me, there's a gray Nike backpack, USA backpack.
Oh yeah.
Which I really liked. I thought that was pretty sweet. So I'm adding that one to the wish list. And then I also saw kind of a collaboration with Baseballism. There looked like a half zip Baseballism hoodie pullover that I really, really liked. So both of those two items will be on my wish list this year for sure.
That is the ever popular Baseballism Henderson Flagman half zip hoodie is the exact item name for those listening that think that might be something that they want. Well, cool. Jeff, we really do appreciate the time. Hope Ann Arbor and being back there is good to you as you try and finish up a degree and get some tossing in with your friends up there. Best to you and yours this holiday season, and we'll catch up again soon, I'm sure.
Yeah, you as well. Thank you so much, Darren. I appreciate you guys having me on.